Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Attack of the Beat Team. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I got a really exciting episode for you. I'm here hanging out on my spawn area, riding Elmer, taking Elmer out for a ride. You know, he needs to go for a walk as well. Maybe, oh, there's a little guy there. Little Boy Scout. Hey, bub. Hey, no, I don't want to buy cookies. What, you're a Boy Scout, not a Girl Scout? All right, well, you're dead. You're dead! So, guys, how you doing? How's the family? Let's get started with today's episode. You know what we're going to do. We're going to induct some cosmonauts into the Hall of Cosmonauts. If you guys don't know what that is, the Hall of Cosmonauts is the place where I make a statue of all of you awesome subscribers out there. And if you would like to be added to the Hall of Cosmonauts, go ahead and drop a comment with your in-game Minecraft name so I can make a statue of you up in my Galacticraft space station. So let's head up there now using our enhanced portals to the Hall of Cosmonauts. Here we go. We got a couple supplies here. Let's grab 4 blocks, 2 pallets, 2 signs, and in here, my statue's hammer. So as always, we do a really quick who's in it already. We got Pro Beast, Blue Can 01, Dirtman 4, Mr. Billy Bob, and I will learn how to say your name if you tell me in the comments. Hafiz the Killer. All right, so let's take a look in the Book of Cosmonauts at the next person. So that would be Jack Dognose. Jack, you've been waiting patiently, and it's now your time. So let's put your sign up first. Let me look here. Jack Dognose. Okay. And let's get the hammer out. One quick last thing, is it, look at the capitalization, yes. So we'll do capital A, J. There you are, Jack Dognose. Let's give you a splash of color, shall we? Boom, that is a cool skin, dude. You got your headset, got your CIA glasses, your suit. You're looking spiffy, dude. Really love the skin. Thank you so much for commenting and subscribing. Who do we got next? Hey, Pallet, get out of there. Jeez. Take a look in the Book and Quill, and that is going to be Dempsey the Block. TWG underscore Pyro. Let's do it. TWG underscore Pyro. Sculpt it. Paint it. Herobrine! In my Hall of Cosmonauts, what are you doing to me, dude? So let's go ahead and make sure I spelled Dempsey the Block right. I think that should be right. There you are, Dempsey the Block. Again, guys, if you want to be included in the Hall of Cosmonauts, put that comment below. Let me know you want to be in there and your in-game name, and I'll make a statue of you to be forever remembered in this awesome space station called the Hall of Cosmonauts. All right, on with the show. Okay, guys, this might look familiar to you. We're back at our Witch Tower. And last episode, I did set a goal for myself to make the Barking Belt to try out the Witchery armor that Chimney Swift uses. We almost got there, but the last steps that we needed to make it required us to head into the Spirit Realm. So let's do a quick recap of what we did so far. Let's bring up this here. So we wanted to make a Barking Belt, and that required us to make a Biting Belt. Which we got ourselves a parasitic louse, and we found that we can make the put those in the auto spawner to get more if we want. Got that done. Maleficious Oh God, I'm never gonna learn how to say that. We get that from killing a nightmare in the spirit realm. And impregnated leather and golden thread, easy peasy to make, just use any eye. Just some leather, diamond vapor, whiff of magic. Golden thread is some hay with some whiff of magic. Now we want to move forward to the bark belt. Now that's going to require two ant twigs, which we have already. Creeper heart, we got it. Emerald, we got it. Pretty much everything except for the brew of flowing spirit. Now, this is pretty easy to make. Need some fanciful thread, Spanish moss, water artichoke, glint weed, mandrake, and wool of bat. We have all these things, but the only issue is we can't brew it in the overworld. The brew of flowing spirit must be made in the spirit world. So I went into the spirit world before I started recording. I spent a lot of time. You might notice this episode's a day late. And I do apologize, but I am going to make it worth it, because look at what I have done in the spirit world. I've been hard at work, guys. Ooh, we got a dream in the first try. Perfect. Here it is. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. We have a proper witch house. Now, this is not done. This is pretty much the layout of the exterior. Now, I want to add lots of details, aging the building a little bit, maybe using a different type of glass. The roof I'm really happy with. Let's take a look at some of the features. Of course, in the front here, we have a nice little sheltered area in case it's raining when we're coming in. And then we have a nice big roof and a witchy tower. What witch abode does not have a tower, right? We needed to have that. And in the back, we have another little entry exit to the backyard where we have some farmy area set up so that we could get some of the mandrake and other stuff that we need for the brew of flowing spirit. All right, other than that, we needed some eggs for Mutandis. So we got a couple of chickens hanging out in here making eggs for us. A small cactus farm, just a very simple, whenever a cactus grows, it's gonna automatically break, and it's either gonna fall back on the cactus and break itself, or fall in the water and go into the hopper, into here. You can do this in vanilla if you want, guys. Pretty easy design. It's not high yield, it's not efficient, but it gives you cactus, and who needs like crazy amounts of cactus? You just need a little bit and you're fine. Okay, inside is not much to speak of. Got a couple steam dynamos powering some junk. No big deal. We're not going high tech here very much. Up here in the witch tower, don't have much either. Nothing on this floor. And up here, I got an enchanting table. So it's really early phases. Just did the layout. But I did want to show you guys what I had so far. There is a loft area up here with a staircase. I'm gonna move this stuff and make it double wide, and it goes up to here to a bed. There's no need for a bed here because it explodes and ruins my house. Great, thank you. Wow. Alright guys, a quick lesson: don't use a bed in the spirit realm. Jesus! Freaker! Okay, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm not upset at all. Everything is back to normal, I believe. There was a dragon egg that I found there. That's not there anymore. But let's just get back to work here. We are not decorating this episode. We're working. Let me put away all the stuff that I had to rebuild my little faux pas, and what we need to do is make some brews flowing spirit. So what do we need? What do we need, baby? So we need Spanish moss. So I know right away that is going to require some mutandis, and we're going to need some glint weed as well. That requires some mutandis. So how do we make mutandis? We need some wood ash. I think I have in her. No, I don't. We're going to have to burn up some oak saplings. We got some bones, and I have made myself a lumbar axe. So I'm going to, off camera, farm up some of some more oak saplings to make wood ash. What else do we need? We have eggs. We have mandrake. Hint of rebirth. That I believe is. Hold on, I'm checking my wiki. Witchery mod for Minecraft wiki. And let's just search for rebirth. So the hint of rebirth is burning spruce saplings in the oven. So I'm going to farm up some oak saplings. Grow. Grow, my pretty. There we go. And I'm going to search the world for some spruce saplings. We should have some. There's a snowy biome right over there. There's definitely spruce that away. And I'll be right back with you guys in a mo, and we'll make some mutandis. Okay, we back. I got a lot of saplings now. So I grabbed some of this cacti, put it to smelt, because we're going to need some cactus green. We're all set there. And now to get wood ash, you just burn some oak saplings. That'll give you wood ash. If you burn any sapling, it'll also give you wood ash. So we'll get that burning. Now, usually, if you put some fume funnels on the side here, just check NEI how to make them. Gives you a higher percent chance. We got some exhaled of the horned one, which is good. But we're going to need some of the spruce ones. So let's burn the sprucey wood. Okay, so we got that going. Two more burn up, and we'll be able to make our mutandis. We're going to get 8 from 1. Let's grab an egg, shall we? Hello, Mr. Cheeking. We need some of your babies. Thank you. And then here I have some of the mandrake root. What else? Hint of rebirth is, should be in here, I hope. Oh, it's not giving me because... Oh, I'm a derp. Alright, so we got... The wood ash goes in the corner, cactus green on top, egg in the center. Cactus green, wood ash, wood ash, wood ash, wood ash. We got mandrake root on the left, and may I have some bone meal, please? Thank you. And here's our hint of rebirth. Pop that there. And we have our mutandis. It's very important to get started in Witchery. Because now we have what we need, hopefully, to get some of the Brew of Flowing Spirit stuff going. Let's bring that up on NEI, because we're going to need some Spanish moss, some glint weed, and everything else we have. And then we're going to need fanciful thread, so we're going to have to make a spinning wheel, too. But let's see if we get some glint weed and Spanish moss. All I have to do is take a sapling, or you could even take a piece of grass and hit it with the mutandis. Alright, we got an alder sapling. Not what we're looking for, but very good. Lily pad, no good. Rowan, good. That's not what we're looking for, but also good. Ah, glintweed. Perfecto. Now we have one glintweed. The awesome thing about it is that's all we need. We'll pop it here, and that's going to just grow on its own. Very beautiful, very magical. Alright, what else are we looking for? We're looking for Spanish moss. Come on, baby. Nether wart. No, thank you. But that is, I think, the only way to get nether wart in this realm. That's good. Ah, dang it. We're out in the mutandis now. Let's go grab another egg. Hey guys, give me your babies. And we should have some more. Yeah, we got plenty now. So, if I remember correctly, like that, like that, like that. Eggs in the center, cactus green. Where's my mandrakes? I left them outside. Grab these guys real quick. Bling, blong. And bone meal, and in the bottom, grab our hints of rebirth, and let's get 16 this time. Okay, keep trying. go mutate some more grass, shall we? Fern. Jungle sapling, I don't need. No. No, come on, give me some Spanish moss. Ember moss is okay. We're gonna let that spread. I hope I could break this. It's not worth the risk. Let's grab some shears, shall we? Iron, please. Because every good witch has a pair of shears in their bag, don't they? So this stuff is cool, but it'll burn you if you walk on it. Although I have the fire protection gene from Advanced Genetics, but it's annoying to walk on. So let's just put it somewhere less annoying. Like out here. Still close by, but won't cause us any grief. Grow, my pretty. Grow. Alright, let's try and mutate some of these oak saplings. See if we have better luck. No. Good lead, come on. Ouch. Give me some Spanish moss, please. Come on. Last one. Cross your fingers, guys. Dang it! Well, I'm going to keep working on this off camera because it's going to be a little bit more grindy than I was hoping. But I will be right back. We did it, guys! We got Spanish moss, baby! And we have all three of the witchery types of woods. Here is our rowan. We have two alder saplings and a hawthorn sapling. So make sure when you get your Spanish moss, use shears. We have our shears, and now we'll just pop it here on the wall and let that grow naturally. And that's going to give us some Spanish moss. That's going to grow naturally. Glintweed's going to grow naturally. And the ember moss is going to be over there growing naturally. We do not need that for the brew of flowing spirit. However, look at that. We already got a second Spanish moss. And while I was trying to get this first Spanish moss, I got a second glintweed so we could make our first brew of flowing spirit. But to do so, we're going to need a kettle. Where are you, kettle? Ooh, there's kettles from Food Plus. This is new. Cool. All right, so the kettle, we need an attuned stone and a cauldron, some string and two sticks. To get the attuned stone, we're going to need a bucket of lava, whiff of magic. Whiff of magic is from burning a rowan sapling. So some more grindy work in our future. We're going to have to get some more rowan saplings. And we're going to have to get, what was the other thing? Just rowan saplings and a bucket of lava. So real quick, I wanted to show you guys, I found a skeleton spawner. So we're running low on bones. So I might AFK here a little bit to produce myself some, check it out, here's the skeleton spawner. Here they come! Kill them quick. Give me your bones. Give me your friends. Perfect. So I'm going to grab some more bones, I'm going to grow some more rowan saplings, and get some whiffs of magic. Smell that? It's magic. Hey, we got a second glintweed. Things are going well for us today. Alright, so let's get some bone meal. Let's get rid of these arrows, and let's get rid of some of this junk. These seeds and such. Could delete this bow. Pop that in there. Flower, whatever. Alright, let's grow a rowan tree. Now, interesting thing about the witchery woods, when you grow them, is that there's a chance when you cut them down that an ent will spawn. Have you seen Lord of the Rings? The ents, the big giant tree guys? Now you're gonna hear like a little ding when you cut it down, and that gave us so many saplings. That was amazing. Amazeballs! All right, let's do another one. Grow, my pretty. Oh, no end that time. That's cool. We're gonna want some ants to spawn because we're gonna need ant twigs, I believe, at some point. And that's the only way you could get those. So let's keep on cutting. Raining saplings. Love this. And ants are just cool with me killing their friends. I'm cool with that. If you cool with that, ant. Alright. So I guess that is enough rowan saplings to get us started here. Let's pop these in the cook. Let that get done. I'm going to organize up my inventory and we'll be right back. Alright, so we got everything needed to make a tombstone. It's not going to happen easily. We got to put a whiff of magic, a diamond, and a bucket of lava. Let's do this twice, actually. Diamond go here. Give me one of tombstone. And one more. Perfect. Now we have our tombstone. Let's grab some iron to make a cauldron and some sticks and string. I was about to break in the song there. Good thing I stopped myself. String should be... Oh, and the mob drops chest. Very disorganized here. Alright, let's get that going. I don't have sticks. Give me two planks. Make them into sticks. And kettle. Not gonna happen. Oh, we need a cauldron. Doi. Alright, this time. Kettle. Yeah. Alright, the kettle needs to be below a source of fire. And that's a problem for us. Because there's no netherrack in here. Whew. How, I guess we just have to put regular wood there and burn. But I read if the wood goes out while you are brewing something, bad things will happen. Alright, so here we're going to want a infinite water source. So let's just do a little corner job here. Grab two buckets of water. There's water. Thank you and thank you. Alright, we put one bucket there, one bucket there. We need more iron to get a flint and steel to get this rocket and rolling. Or do I have a flint and steel in my tool bag? I do have one. I prepared. Ouch. Okay. So we're gonna have to fill the kettle with water. And now, is the wood supposed to be that close up? I don't think so. Let's grab that wood out of there and put it one block further down. Okay. Now let's make sure we have all the ingredients we need. We need Fanciful Fred. You guys, you forgot to remind me. So we're going to need a spinning wheel. Spinning wheel. We need four item frames. Another tombstone, a stick, and two planks. Easy enough. Give me many sticks. Give me some leather. And let's just autocraft like that. It's easier. Are you kidding me? We ran out of stick? Some old stick. Eight more will definitely do the job. Alright, and let's go grab, I have wool over here. Piece of wool. What else we got missing here? A charge of tombstone. I think we got everything. Let's give it a try. Nope. We got wool. We got a stick. We got a tombstone. We need more wood. That's what she said. Just kidding. JK, y'all. JK Rowling. Oh man, I'm bad today. I'm sorry, guys. Let's pop that there. Now, it needs an altar also. Great. Let's make some altars. I think we have everything we need. Altar. Exhale the horned one. Let's cook up some sprucey wood. Yes. I have one. I don't have any more spruce wood than that. All right. Let's cook up some wood. And that will give us some exhale to the horn one. And then we're going to have to cook up some birch to give us the breath of the goddess. We don't need that. That wood ash could go up there. Blue hydrangea. You gone. Mob drops go in there. Just organizing my chest, guys. Oops, you don't go there. You go in that witchy chest. You go in here, Flint. Buckets. It's raining? That's just a dream. It don't rain in your dreams. Alright, that's only one hint of rebirth. We need more. Give us more. I think I have more clay jars here. Yep. Make sure we keep that stocked. That'll ruin your day. And let's put this back. So we get an altar going. Now this is going to give us 3 pieces of altar. We want 6, so you have to make this twice. So we need 2 breaths of the goddess. Oh no, we don't need the Bruce almighty. We need the exhale of the horned one. That comes from oak sapling. Ooh, Derp City, y'all. So we cook that up. And then from the spruce sapling, we'll get Breath of the Goddess. Gotcha. All right, let's get that cook up. And I'll be right back with y'all in a moment. All right, we're all set. So to make the altar, let's grab 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's make these into stone bricks. 2 on each side. Skype going off like a crazy. And Breath of the Goddess is on the left. Get that from here. Oh, we still gotta cook our birch wood. Guys, why don't you tell me? Alright, so we got that. Put that away. And now the altar draws its power from the nature around. So I'm gonna pop the altar down here. And the spinning wheel requires altar power. You see why it has that. And let's see how we make that fanciful thread so we can get that ready to go. So we're going to need an odor of purity that comes from hawthorn saplings getting cooked up in the witchy oven. Let's do that up now, baby. Do that up now, baby. Do that up now, baby. All right. Popping this down. Let's grow and cut. Let's hope we get an ent, because that would be fun to fight here, right, guys? Oops, pick it up. Thank you. No ent that time. Hawthorn. Hawthorn, why you no break right? I'm cutting this tree down. It'll probably make everything disappear. It all disappear. Alright, more hawthorn, please. I'm surprised maybe ants don't spawn in the spirit world. That was a lot of saplings. Let's put some to cook. No hints of rebirth yet. Are you kidding me? Our breaths of the goddess. Goddess, breathe on me. Come on, baby. I'm gonna need some more birch leaves or saplings. Got it. Grow, my pretty. Bones are like a super hot commodity. All these growing I gotta do. Got half a stack of bone meals. Pick up this junk. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And into here. tell me you gave me one now. Thank you. I need one more, please. Thank you. If you ask nicely, guys, it works better. So now we can pop our Breath of the Goddess here, and we need two water bottles. I have sand, or glass. Sand, aka glass. Right here. Let's make it in the bottle. There you go. And let's fill up these bottles, baby. Man, all this work for just a armor. But this armor is really cool, guys. It's gonna be worth it. Alright, and let's grab our... Where is it? There it is. Our whiskey cotton, so that we could get the process going a little quicker here. Let's see. Get a sleep job. And when you connect it, you see we have an altar with 1,325 altar power. Not a lot, but let's see what we got here. Alright, let's try this. We need Odor of Purity, please. I think that said string. String and Odor of Purity. Did this finish cooking? Yes, perfect. String, thank you. Die! Die, sucker! Alright, so let's put that here. Put that. And Odor of Purity. It's going! Alright, so... This is Scarab. Let's make some more. How many is that going to be? Just one. Let's make two. Actually, we should make four. Let's see if we have more Odor of Purity here. We do. We do. Because we need four Brews of Flowing Spirit. Actually, no. Okay. Yeah, we just need two more. Let's take out one more. So that'll cook up here. Oh my. Jeez. How many do you use? Oh, you use so much. Not good. Alright. That's fine. That's fine. Let's make some more bottles. Give me that glass. That glass, though. And we'll get that, fill up E6. Wait, they should not be filled up. Oh, I'm stuck in the mud. Empty these up. I'll make up my mind one day. Alright, that's full of water. Let's get all the materials we need now together. Flowing spirit. So, Spanish moss. Spanish moss. I'm gonna set it up here. Spanish moss, fanciful thread, glintweed, and water artichoke. Let's grab those. Got a glintweed right now. Water artichoke right on over here. Okay. A mandrake root and a wool of bats. Mandrake root's inside of blue. And so is the wool of bat. Alright, so here's what we have to do now. We're gonna light this piece of wood up, okay? And then we're gonna throw all six of these ingredients. And then we're gonna scoop it up with these glass bottles. Here we go, guys. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Brews of Flowing Spirit are flowing, baby. And we got 3. So we need to do that one more time. And put that out. So we got a second one of these. We're going to need a second. Where are you? Oh, it's up here. Wool of Bat and Mandrake. We're gonna need another glint weed, another... What else was it? I'm gonna use a cheat sheet. Glint weed and water artichoke. And what goes on the top there? Spanish moss. That's easy enough. It's probably growing a whole bunch like crazy. Look at that. Alright, let's do it one more time. Let's fill up our water bucket as well. We're gonna need that actually. Don't need that. Bucket, please. There it is. Put that back in there. Okay, so we have our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ingredients. Light it up one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's bubbling. Take it. Nice! We have 6 brews of flowing spirit. Let's take a look at Barking Belt. Where are you? There it is. I have those. All right, everything else. I have everything else. So, now, when I prick myself with this icy needle, I should be back in my witch tower, and I should still have my brews of flowing spirit. Let's give it a test. Yes! I have them. Do you know what that means? That means we are going to have a Barking Belt, ladies and gents. Let's check our future. I will be saved by a stranger. Thanks, stranger. So we take our Barking Belt. We take our 2 Ant Twigs. A Creeper Heart. We're going to need a... Let's go home. Let's grab an emerald. Do I have any Lucy emeralds? Yes, I do. So quiet out here now. Emerald. Alright, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Yeah, that's everything I need. Let's just do it in the Witch Tower because we can. So, Barking Belt, or Bark Belt. Doesn't work. Just do it like this. And we do it like that. Put the 4 brews of flowing spirit in here. And twigs there. Creeper Heart on the bottom. Emerald on the top. Bark Belt. Alright, so we have the Bark Belt. Now let's trade armor with Chimmy here. So let's put on our new armor set. We have a Seeking Shoes, Witch's Hat, Witch's Robes, and when we put this Bark Belt on, now we're standing on the grass. Let's look at ourselves. Yep, you hear that? I'm getting wood growing on my body. You guys see the wood? Look, there's my pants. Got some on my arm. How sweet is this, guys? So now, every time I get hit, instead of taking the damage, the actual, as you see on my, right here where my armor is. Let's go back to this one. Where my armor is, there are little sticks growing. And whenever you're standing on grass, your sticks will regrow. Slowly but surely. But don't call me Shirley. Alright, guys? So, that's some powerful armor. Let's say we test it out. Alright, I'm here in my enchanting room, and I just wanted to show you guys what happens when we take off the Barking Belt and enchant it, what our armor will look like then. So let's go ahead and take our Bark Belt, and let's put Protection 4 on it. Definitely Unbreaking 3. And Last Stand 2. Alright, and we're going to want to put some Protection and Unbreaking on our hat. Unbreaking 3. We're definitely going to want some Aqua Affinity on it, in case you have to go underwater, and some Respiration. So now we have a enchanted hat, and our boots. Let's put some Protection 4, Unbreaking 3. We don't need Feather Falling because we don't take fall damage because of our Fly Gene. So, barking bell on. Now look at this. Whoo, boy! I got magic wood, baby. I got the magic stick. So, what were we? Oh yeah, we were gonna test. Let's give it a test. Now I'm gonna fight this guy the old-fashioned style using my bow and my sword. No flying. And let's see how we handle a wither boss. Now, it is true that I'm immune to the wither effect, but hey, it's a good way to see how we stack up. Oh man, those sticks go fast. It's a good thing I have a massive amount of hearts. My owl game is helping me. Go, Hooter! Oh no, Hooter! But that was not too bad at all. I think my owl died though. Hooter, is that you? I'm sorry. Guys, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. And if you did enjoy this video, hit that like button for me. I'd really appreciate it. Alright guys, so, what? Where's, oh, I didn't even have all my armor on, and we blasted him. But anyways guys, I'll see you later, cosmonauts!